that. All right. Champ 3 game. My man. Can I buy a bottle of your jizz? You're really interesting, man. Yeah, sure. Okay, you're trying to come down. Can you just try and not do anything on the walls if there is no one here? Like, just try and come down here. Let the ball roll out. When you're here. Hey. Hey, man. How are you doing, bro? I'm doing great. I just got gifted 50 subs. What do you think? I'm talking to a wall. There is a wall next to me, bro. Look at my hair. Ugly as fuck. Look at what you do to me. Sorry, I'm just supporting your dream. Touch me. Moving out to me. Oh, that's cute, man. I just fucking came. You. I don't know what to say, man. I really don't know what to say. I'm not good with showing my appreciations. But I appreciate you a lot. I really do. Thank you so much, man. Like, I literally don't know what to say, but I'm really fucking grateful for you. You're a fucking show legs. Just show your feet. I'm not gonna fuck off. OnlyFans, go buy my feet pics. I'm kidding, but you know, what's up, Trev? Cry maybe? I'm not gonna fake fucking cry, cuck. You're the best, I appreciate yellow. My phone just fell, bro. Shadow Puppet Man, I met you like 2 days ago or some shit. Do the review, cuck. Lord Shadow, let me talk to you a little bit. I met you like 2 days ago, right? Ansley was like, yo, this is a good guy. I appreciate your presence. Missing another sub, thank you. I'll get to it. Liam is vibing. Thank you for the tier 3 for 11 months, man. Is that D Liam? Or isn't it? But thank you for Flicky be blushing. True. Thank you for the tier 3, Liam. Thank you for the 11 months, man. Shadow Puppet, I met you like 2 days ago, 3 days ago. You talked, and I was like, I kind of like this man's presence, right? He's a good guy. I like talking to him. Thanks for being here, man. You came back next day. I was happy. You know, I saw you in chat. I was like, hey, man, great. We got another cuck. We baited another cuck into my stream in my life. I fucking trapped you into my life. Welcome. But that doesn't mean you have to gift fucking 17 million subs, homie. And that's kind of what you're doing right now. And it's costing you money. And I don't know if you're fucking Bill Gates or some shit. But, you know, you can save your money and you'll be fine. But thanks for supporting, man. That's all I can say. I appreciate it a lot, dude. It's your choice, your money, your shit, but it really is fine if you do save your money, but I don't want to sound ungrateful, so it means a lot to me, and it does help out, and, you know, thank you for everything, man, for real. Thanks for being here. Thanks for your existence. Thanks for your generosity, man. Appreciate you, dude. All right. Try to come fucking... Let's do this replay right now, right? So try to come down the fucking wall, right? So you turn away from the ball like this. Like this, I'll show you, because some retards are always like, I don't know how to turn. You turn like this, right? You come down here. This ball is going to roll like this, right? One of them is going to challenge. The first guy is going to challenge. So when you don't want to hit it on goal instantly. When he challenges, we hit the right side of the ball, so the ball bounces left. So we hit the ball to the left side, it bounces from this wall back into middle. So this guy's going to challenge in a straight line. Like, he's going to challenge like this, right? Do you notice how this is all open? This whole area is open. If he challenges like this, he challenges like this, right? This whole area is open. So you use it. You're here. The ball's gonna roll down like this. So you hit it to the left side without jumping, without flipping. Just drive into the fucking ball and hit it to the left. That was so Kappa Pride Flex. I was just appreciating him. J-Daw is too late. I literally waited 20 minutes on J-Daw. It's his own fault, bro. J-Daw, I asked you like 10 minutes, man. Get your bitch ass out of here, bro, man. I'm sorry, J-Daw, but we'll do yours soon then. It's not my fault. I tried. So you try to come down, try to get an inside play touch. Now, if the ball goes over your fucking head, and you've tried to do your play, we're playing twos here. You're a fucking retarded ball chaser, and you're a fucking monkey if you do this, because this is not your fucking ball. You grab this boost if it's there, and rotate away. If it's not there, we rotate away. You don't fucking turn. You've tried to do something, and now you leave, right? So you've done the shit, you fucked up, because you jumped off the fucking wall and hit the ball into nothing. You leave, you grab a pad, you grab boost if it's here. This boost isn't here, you can grab some pads and be here, right? Your teammate is not going to do something and then you're behind him. Don't fucking turn and don't fucking do this shit. Wow, you beat one guy. Oh, there's another guy. Oh my god, your team is not gonna get baited in because he's like, oh, this is a pass and I could... Why scam? Literally told you I've accepted my fate. I mean, I didn't scam you. I was here and, you know, I was ready for you, but you weren't here, right?
Enjoy the rest of your stream, chat.
That's cute, Lunaris. Thanks for being here. I appreciate you. Thank you for the biddies. Hope you have a wonderful day, Ubu, Owo, Ayaya, Senpai. Have a good day, for real. Thanks for being here, Luna-chan. So you beat this fucker, right? So now your team is like, oh man, I could score this. But the problem is there's another guy. So now your teammate gets beaten, you beat him in. It's your fucking fault. You should have just left and your teammate could have gone for the ball. You went back and now you would have been fine, right? So you could shoot. Double jump, you should have a save. Nice save. Try to grab boost, first priority. Don't hit this. Time. You might get bumped on. If he hits, that's fine. Just turn around and go again. If he hits, fine. Just turn. You know, free ball now. You don't want to hit this away. You have to block this because this is threatening, but make sure you don't just flip forward because then you're probably going to hit it away because you might beat him, right? That's fine. Boost might spawn on you. Your teammate shouldn't have done this, but don't turn into this fucking wall. You have to realize there's an opponent that could be there and that could hit it on target, right? So if your teammate does this, you don't just turn left, like, going like this. You know, you can grab the boost, but make sure you, after, you know, you are in a position where you could go on net if this guy, like, turns and shoots now. Because if he shoots now... Where are you? You're sitting behind him, you're not. You don't sound ungrateful, that's the shit, that's the shit, you're genuine, you're a simple guy who treats everyone in this chat like your friends. I can't seem to find such connection in other streams, YouTubes, you name it. You're a smart guy, you have a team of cucks to support you, and I'm one of them. That's so cute, man. It warms my heart, man. It really does. But now, like, I don't know, like, I said, fuck, it's like, I say something cute to you, and then you fucking write a whole ass fucking essay, and now it's my turn again, but I don't have anything to say other than I appreciate you, you know, fuck off, dude, it warms my peen, I appreciate it, man, I'm a writer, my man, I thought about writing, dude, writing is kind of cool, I was maybe thinking about writing a whole book about my fucking life after I'm done with Rocket League and shit, but we'll see, man, maybe in the future. You almost got a hit into the opponent. Now you're like, oh, I shouldn't get a hit. So then you go back. But why don't you just back up now? Why don't you just fucking wait here and be in a good position? Why fucking push up and then be like, oh, I shouldn't get a hit. And then you fuck up yourself. Just fucking wait here. I'd read that shit. That shit's gonna be good. That's a lie. I don't know how to fucking write. There's probably gonna be cuck in the sentence every 2 seconds, right? So you're gonna flick it past one, which I'm not a big fan of, unless you double jump here, but I'm still not a big fan of that. I would rather want you to get clean outplays, so that would be... You fuck up, right? Which is fine. First of all, just wait here to have a free ball, you know, wait for one to challenge, hit it over, and that's it. If this happens, you fuck up, that's fine, right? You should notice no one challenges you. So you get one hit into middle, right? One hit rolling like this, a soft hit. You wait for one to challenge, when he challenges, power slide cut it to the left side, it's gonna go here, this guy's gonna challenge, this one of them gone, and now it's a 1v1. You can follow the shot up because you haven't jumped, you haven't flipped. Whereas now you're either gonna flip or you're gonna double jump. You get a double jump, which is better than a flip. If you flip it past the first guy, then, you know, the guy's just gonna save it. But with the double jump, you still have a chance of doing something. But again, I don't like it because you're still committing. I would still rather have you get clean outplays. That would mean outplays without jumping, without flipping. And that would mean not going straight towards the opponents, but actually, you know, having direction changes with parts like cuts or fakes or anything you're comfortable with. But just, you know, try to do stuff, right? This guy deserves it, he's humble. That's the shit. Giphy, you're fucking cute. I appreciate your presence as well. You're a good guy. This is a good drive challenge. This is bad control though, nice try. I would, you know, leave this ball. You do your drive shit. You're a fucking ball chaser, Junior. You really are. You do a drive challenge, that's fine. When the ball goes over your head, you have to leave, right? So either, you know, I feel like you should have turned left as opposed to, you know, driving right. You don't turn into the shit. You're gonna drive challenge like this. Make sure you turn left now so that you always turn into net because you might lose the 50. Don't just turn up and feel like you're gonna win every 50 like a fucking god, you know? So turn left after challenging so you can always be back, right? It's the fast way back. So if you lose the 50, you're not gonna cuck yourself and be upfield, right? Don't expect yourself to win every fucking 50. So you hit the shit, you should turn left, and now you should notice your team is there and then it's his ball, right? Since you turn right, you're always also under the ball. I would just leave if you turn right. If your teammate is there, he gets the ball. If he's not there, we make another turn, and now we're in a good position to still go for the ball. So it's still your ball if your teammate isn't there. But if your teammate is there, then he's gonna get a free, you know, then your teammate gets the ball, right? Have a good day, J-Dot. Thanks for being here, man. Sorry for scamming. I tried. I tried to give you time, but I was in free play and it got awkward, and I did someone else's replay. What's up, McDog? What's up, Android? right? But you don't want to stay under the ball, not knowing if there is opponents, not knowing if there is teammates, not knowing, you know, not knowing shit. So you either just leave, unless you had 100% awareness of who's where everyone is, but you really didn't have. And then you use 40 boost for no reason, because you probably thought someone was closer, which is unfortunate, but that's the problem of staying under the ball. You don't really have vision of anything. Back boost, free ball. Jump is there. If there is a guy behind you who could bump you, then fucking jump, right? Your decision making is really slow. It needs to be way faster. You need to flip here. Grab this fucking boost. After grabbing this boost, we make it look like we challenge, and that's just staying here. Then we go for back boost, right? Instantly go for back boost, turn around, fake challenge, or challenge if it's a free ball. But your decision making needs to be faster, right? Here, this guy's behind you, right? If this guy's behind you, it could mean he's gonna bump you. So you have to fucking be aware of the bump. You're just sitting here. Whereas, you know, this guy is stupid because he just goes for the ball. If this guy rotated like this, tell me, are you jumping? No, you're not fucking jumping. So he could flip you all the way fucking up here. He could flip you on the fucking sidewall if you wanted to. So have bump awareness. Go fucking play ones. You don't play ones enough. You're showing a lot of mistakes. A lot of, like, slow decision making, right? Stop trying to control the ball this much, man. Time. You fuck up because you're trying to control and you miss the control, right? Whereas if you just fucking took your time, maybe you got one soft touch into this shit, grab this mid boost and then try to control, you would have been maybe been better. But you do have to know that you have time. If you don't know, go play once. Learn it then. Go fuck up in once and get scored on, please. That's a good boost grab though. Go behind your teammate. We'll play. That's a useless bump. Don't fuck it. What the fuck is this, bro? Just turn. Turn opposite side of the player, here, go here, right? When your teammate does some shit, we can push up a little bit, he's gonna get 50 now, so we wait. If this 50 is lost, we're here, and now we can push up into middle, we have 100 boosts, we're middle, we can help out. Alright, don't be weird. Don't do weird shit. Shout out to your teammate, best player ever. He's getting a bit tilted at the time. Why don't we just send me a replay where you're tilted, bro? 25 bucks wasted. Don't go inside the net and commit too much for bumps. Back boost. One pad, you should be fine. Let's try. Bump. Let's try. Go behind your teammate. You're cutting rotation. Why are you going towards that side? Stay on the opposite side of the play. It's not that hard. Here, this is your ball. That's two pads, three pads. Get some value and weight here. Your teammate's not going to try something. You can say it. We can push up, right? Your fucking positioning and movement is so fucking scuffed. Be middle. If he gets a hit, we have to be middle, right? Oh, he gets a hit, okay, we'd be middle. Why the fuck would you be on the right side? Yes, if he loses the 50, you can be right side. But if you're middle and he loses the 50, we can still go right side. You don't want to be right side because if you're middle, you're committing for either he gets a beat and you're there for a free goal. But if he gets beaten, you can always turn right. If you're right, if he gets a pass middle, you can't teleport to middle and still fucking score. But yes, you're in a great position for if he loses the 50. But you have to be in a position where you can be ready for both. Being right is too passive, whereas this one is fine because we can push up now and try to score. Or at least pressure. You might not be able to score because he's right there, but we can pressure, go for boost, turn around. Is he here? Fake challenge, go back. He's going to hit it, grab this boost. Same shit. If he's here, fake challenge, go back. If he's not here, grab boost, turn around, free ball. Go for clean possessions, don't go for 50s. Right? Now you can't get his boost and that's a mistake. Should be a free ball. Control. That's so fucked up. You have time to, you have all this fucking space to play. This guy's gonna land behind you. If this guy's gonna land behind you, don't fucking play this back. This is too shit, too passive, too cuck. You're gonna give that guy a free rotation back. Whereas you fucking got a touch up here, grab this boost maybe, or just went for a play. You know, get a touch and get a play, so you get rid of this guy, but you know, by playing faster. Don't play fucking slow so you don't punish this guy. If he gives you a ball and he's gonna land behind you, then punish this fucking guy for giving you ball possession. Wait, Flex is 5'6", can't be a Dante, shut up, homie. I'm 5'7" on a good day, bro. You know, get a touch, pass this guy, grab boost, and then try to create a play. It's a 1v1, take your 1v1s, don't play back, right? Time, if he challenges you, let it... No! Give away your possession. Free ball, grab your back boost, grab your back boost, grab your back boost, grab your... Is it that hard? It's just fucking listening. Grab shit, he hits ball. It's going to a position where it's non-threatening. Can you see that? Are you blind? No, you're not. So can you see that? Yes. Is this going on target? No, it's not. Grab boost. Be on the wall where the ball's gonna land. Be here. Wait. We get the boost. We get a ball touch. It goes forward. We come here. don't get a hit anymore. Get one touch here and don't get a hit. You don't even have to get a hit. You can literally position yourself here so this ball bounces and we get one hit now to the left so we outplay this guy. Don't fucking get hits earlier. Get this ball boost here and wait for the fucking ball and get in a good position. You're cucking yourself. Your fault. But it's on triggered so that the guy can fucking learn from what he does. Back boost. Don't challenge. Just let him hit it. Stay on the wall though. Free ball. Don't challenge. What's the point of flipping? If you flip, let's say he doesn't hit it. Let's say he doesn't hit it. What is this gonna do? Oh, give way of possession. And then this fucking guy could go. Because you hit it over here. That all he has to do is turn and now it's his ball. Don't hit it away. Never ever. The problem is that you come off the wall and you're not threatened. Like, stay on the fucking wall. He's upright. He could hit this backboard, right? Why come down the wall when he could hit it backwards? Stay here. If he misses, we go down. If he hits, we're still here. Get a touch without jumping or flipping. The ball's literally rolling on the wall. You just sit here. The ball's gonna touch you. It's gonna go here. This guy outplayed himself. You come down and now you try to control. It's not that hard, Junior. You're watching me. You should know, but you know. Do it then. Teammate shouldn't do this. Give away possession. You shouldn't push up. He's shooting. Don't push up into his shot. Your teammate gives away possession. Fine. Know that he's fucking stupid and stay back. Grab this boost maybe. Right? Grab this boost. When you grab this boost, turn left because he's going to shoot, right? If he misses, then we can push up, right? We know that this guy could shoot. We have to watch out again. Look at how far you are. What is this? Now you're in a bad position because you're scary. This and that, right? It is a great boost grab. You notice it's not in and he can't score, so you go for boost as well. Play, return. That's fine. He's going to hit it. He's outplaying himself, right? You should try and control it. You should notice that there is not really anyone here except for this guy. You see that he just spawned there. He's over there all the way. So you can jump up. I will jump up as well. Right? But I wouldn't hit it far away. I would jump up and get a hit slowly in front of me. Or if you have perfect awareness, you'd notice that this guy is not even there. Then you wouldn't jump up because you'd know there's no threat, right? But, you know, it's maybe you didn't notice. But you don't have to hit it away because hitting it away is garb. Why should you never hit this? Because if someone is up, all you have to do is block the angle, right? So you don't have to get power on this shot. Your purpose is to jump up here and block this angle. Again, if you notice he's all the way back, you don't have to jump up, right? But you should jump up because you don't really know. Block the angle, but if no one is there, your purpose is not to hit it away. Your purpose is then to try and keep possession, even if you don't know that someone isn't there. It's not hitting the ball, it's blocking a shot, and if no one is there, we should try and keep possession, right? So you hitting it forward is just giveaway of possession. Stop fucking using boost and, you know, sucking even more. First of all, you don't need 70 fucking boost for this aerial, right? Double jump, 10 boost enough, 20 boost, 30 maybe, okay, but don't use 50. Please, then don't use the remaining 70 to fucking fly towards this cuck. Try to land and try to rotate back right. So you land here, somewhere around here, you go around your team and grab some pants and we're back in position now. Don't try to block this shit. Don't try to be cool. You're not cool. We're trying to win. Be behind your teammate. You're cutting rotation, being a fucking annoying teammate. Stay behind him. It's not that hard. Be here. You're on this side, then stay on this side. Grab pads, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4 pads here. Be behind him. Don't fucking cut rotations. It's not that hard. Now you only have grab one pad and rotations are scuffed. You're still not grabbing pads. 2, 3, 4 pads, bro. It's not that hard. Don't be a cuck. Don't stay back with 12 boosts. Ball is not going on target. Ball is going to a non-threatening position. Grab your fucking boost. Flip. You beat him. Grab boost, turn left. If he's here, if it's not threatening, let him hit it. If it's threatening, you block the angle. That's it. You don't have to get a hit, another hit to the corner and let him beat you to the boost. Grab the fucking boost if they're not going to score anyway. Getting another hit towards the boost is useless. Medium pressure is 50 boost used on the turn. Garbage boost management. More ones, man. You don't want to challenge this shit. Just turn right now. Turn right now like this. When he doesn't fall for it, we go like this. Right? Just keep fake challenging him so he's going to fucking flick it to your back corner or to this mid boost. And then you have a free ball, right? Stop challenging. Stop, you know, pushing up so far. Stop being ugly. This is your teammate's ball. Again, you don't have any fucking attention. You don't pay any attention. You don't pay any regard to your fucking teammates. This is the fucking fifth time this happens. You cut rotation. You fucking ball chase. You bump him. Stop fucking doing this shit. Grab mid boost at least to fucking fix your mistakes. You make a mistake and you make 17 other mistakes on top of your mistake. Go play once, please. Like, I can't believe this is... You don't have to hit it. Let him hit it. Well played. Turn. Free ball. That's great. Really good. Make sure you don't turn into the shit, though. This is a really good low 50 here. Your turn is really shit. There's a lot of stuff to still improve on. You should stay in a position where you cover the ball close so he hits it into you, and after that we can go for the ball hit, right? So don't go up here, but you know, stay here on the wall. Don't jump, don't flip. He's gonna hit this ball on you and then you can just turn with the ball, right? Whereas now you're kind of far away from the ball, right? So that's one thing. It's not really a huge problem, but You could punish him harder if you're closer to the barrier, and there's no threat in doing that. So just block the shit here, then the ball's gonna go here, then you can follow up, right? This happens, hits the ball. This is really smart for you to do this, but kill your momentum here and don't turn right into the 50. The 50 is about to happen now, so don't turn right. Stay here until the 50 is done. 50 happens, we push up now, and we get a free ball. Since you pushed up right, we push up into the 50, and now we're on the right side all of a sudden, right? Garbage. Stay here, say let him 50, and then we push up into the 50. Well played to let him hit the ball over you, though. That's fine. See what happens here, though. So you know your team is here, he's gonna go right. What do? You turn fucking tight into the ball again. No regard, no attention for anything. You see your teammate right there. He's there. Yeah, but Flakes, I'm here, it's my ball. I fucking know. Is your teammate there, though? Yes. So if your teammate is there, don't be fucking stupid. Your teammate is stupid, so let him be stupid, because that's the only thing you can do. You can't change your teammate's actions. He's there, then he's there. Leave, right? Let him be a ball chaser. At least you don't be the ball chaser with him, right? So the turn wouldn't have been the problem. The problem, like, if you notice he's here now, this is still fine as long as you stop here. If you stop here, you're fine. But let's see what you do. He's gonna hit it, right? Oh, let's push up into it. Oh, the hit is scuffed. Well, I pushed up too far. Now I have to rotate again. Whereas if you're here again, you haven't pushed up too far, you're gonna try to fake challenge or do something again, right? Rank is this guy. He's champ 3, if I remember correctly. What's the point of challenging it there? Tell me, please. It's just simple rules. You know not to challenge you, but you still do it because you don't remind yourself of it. And you don't get punished off of it because you have a teammate. So do this in once, please. Please fucking do this in once and get punished for it, please. You beat this guy? Great. There's another guy behind this guy. Your fucking challenge is useless. And if you go up for this and land on the wall and get beaten to this, which you could, 2v1 on your teammate. Lose-lose situation. There's nothing great that could happen out of here. Don't fucking do this shit. You're using boosts and getting out of position for no fucking reason. How is he champ 3? Send me your fucking replay, you guys. Don't be cool. If you're fucking grand champ 1700, you'll still look shit when I watch your replay. No offense, but don't talk shit about my mans. Only I can talk shit, bro. I'm the shit talker. But I'm the shit talker because I can teach him something, right? You know, just... Homie juniors, don't listen to chat, right? Hmm. 44 boosts. Never mind. We've used 40 boosts to hit the ball for no reason. Again, what does that do? You should... Your mentality should be, I'm here. If they hit it, that's fine, because you're going to be back anyway. This guy's back anyway, so speeding up the play, yeah, it would be great, but this guy's going to be back as well. So speeding up the play doesn't do anything. Your mentality should be, since you're going to be back anyway, let me try and take my time. If I get clean possession, I can try and get clean possession like this, grab some passing away, power slide, cut it, maybe. And if they hit it, we're in the corner, I can just rotate as long as I don't fucking commit and push up into the fucking ball every time, right? So we wait here as opposed to jumping. And we get a free ball. If they hit it, free ball. If they don't, if they miss it, 2v1. If they hit it, rotate with the ball. It's that easy. It's not threatening, so you don't fucking hit the ball away from yourself. You don't use fucking 44 boost to recover. Here, same shit. If this ball goes over your head, your teammate gets a free ball. If you fucking 50 it, and the 50 goes in a random ass, unlucky 50. No, it's your fucking fault for 50. If this ball goes over your head, your teammate gets a free ball. If you pinch this shit, and you 50 and you help them out, it's your fault. You shouldn't have 50'd. Let this ball go over your head. Either you get a free clean play over him, or you don't fucking 50, let the ball go over your head, you rotate back, you don't fucking front flip and get out of position, right? So now the 50 goes high. Hey, let's see, oh, it's awkward, because your teammate is also shit, so don't make it hard for him by 50 and leaving him. You could have just left the ball and rotated back, but hey. You can teach without swearing every second word, true, but you know, that's just how I am, so shut your bitch ass up, homie. Useless. So, hey, great flick. Wow! Mechanical skill! Look at that dribble! 1, 2, 3, flick! Such a high flick! What a great play! No. Useless. It doesn't matter if you look cool, it doesn't matter if you hit the flick, it doesn't matter what you do, because it's a pass straight to the fucking opponents. It's possession. If you notice, they're not gonna do anything, they're not gonna score, then stop doing anything. You have ball, take ball, keep ball, please. Right? Don't flick it towards him, because now it's gonna be hard for yourself. So now you're like, maybe I could beat him. I swear to God, maybe I could beat him. If I fucking predict this shit and I hit the read on the fucking wall and I beat him, maybe, let's go. Alright, you try to bump. Fair enough. But still, do you know what it's like, Gary? Don't have to do any of this shit. It's not going in now. Stop getting hits now. This is it. All you have to do. This hit is fine. I have to, but stop using boost. Stop doing anything. If they challenge it, fine. They're overcommitting. It's good if they challenge you because they're overcommitting. You need to take advantage of it. Stop fucking outplaying yourself and stop giving away ball possession, right? Let him challenge here. It's fine. Play this into your corner like you do. Just don't flick. Don't hit it away. Fuck. If they challenge, let them challenge. And otherwise, if they don't challenge, stay behind the ball like this. You were dribbling like this, right? You're dribbling like this. Just wait. If they challenge, let them challenge. Otherwise, we just wait. Whenever they leave, because they don't have boost or they don't want to challenge because they know it's useless, then we can try and create a play, right? You have to go for clean plays. You have to go for clean, you know, possessions, right? I swear to God, I haven't seen you fucking grab pads once in your fucking life. This is risky, but you know, if you want to... How the fuck? I don't want to do this. What was that? Can you please keep your ball cam on that? Can you please rotate? Please keep your ball cam on that. And fucking please rotate. Why would you stop on this boost? You don't have the time. You're relying on the fact that the boost will spawn on you even if you delay it a little bit to have a little bit more chance of getting the boost, but it's not worth it. Because if the motherfuckers just shoot, the motherfuckers will just score. So just fucking rotate. 12 pat is enough. 24, go back to net, free save. Don't fucking kill your momentum because you can't afford it. You were fine. You were fine. I swear to God, you were fine. Go, 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 go. Go, 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 go. You were fine, but you cuck yourself because you're stupid. Go play once and let this happen in once and let it be frustrating. Let it be frustrating, but learn from your mistakes. It's frustrating because you're getting punished, but it's good because you're making a lot of mistakes and you should learn from it. Please don't do fucking fake kickoffs in twos, man. All you're doing is fucking up your teammate. Please, man. You don't do this shit here, man. Yeah, go AFK. Why the fuck would you send me a replay where you mid boost maybe. It's not about the ball. It's not about the ball. This is a decent outplay. It's not about the ball here. If he plays the ball into a position where they can't do anything with it, we can go for boost. Try to get boost. Try to get a demo. So we have free possession after the boost grab or the demo, right? This is a really nice outplay if you get this middle though. Which you do, but you get bum. You know, that's a great outplay. Never mind that boost grab, it's fine. Wait, right, so you could go, but wait, your teammate is there, so let him go. You could shoot that. This position is kind of scuffed, right? Make sure we don't push up this far into the play. Turn left now, he's already up, right? Don't turn up this much. I know it's a little thing, but it's a huge difference. Turn a little bit earlier, he's up. You're not going to do anything, leave. Try to stay on the opposite side, right? Try to rotate like this, grab some pads, and then go like this if you can threaten. Don't challenge, only challenge when you know it's a free ball. Threaten it like that, but don't like turn under the fucking ball here and stay here, right? Turn like this. So when they do the passing play, you see the other guy, you know, he's gonna go for a shot. We can just be here. He's gonna get a shot. Okay, we play into the ball now. Get a free ball. Get boost. Get everything, right? But don't turn. Don't stay on the fucking same side. Don't stay under the ball. Get some fucking... Get a wide turn. So you're coming from one side and having momentum to the other side. So you're covering the whole net as well, right? You can anticipate shots. You can anticipate shit. It's not that hard with your position. You don't want to sit under the fucking ball. Like, if this guy literally shot this, and he got a good shot, at the moment of a shot, where are you? Oh, we're fucking watching this fucking flowers and bushes and shit? That ain't it, Chief. He could shoot this fucking hard right now, you're disrespecting him. If he shot this, bottom right, Tommy was back, not you, because you're AFK, right? Nice boost grab. Nice flip in, or pass into the opponents. If your opponents beat your teammate, then who's back? No one. You fucking help your opponents out. What is that? You missed a boost, hey, it happens, man. Try to at least grab a pad here, right? Try to come down then. Try to do something. You have zero boost. You can still fucking make the opponents overcommit. Your opponents are also retarded, just like you. It's fine. But at least make it awkward for them. Because if you're gonna fucking hit the ball and gonna be out of position, then, you know, your opponents have eyes, I think, I hope. So they're gonna be able to fucking see where the ball is going and they're gonna be able to get a free ball almost if they notice it is a free ball, right? Pog twin. Hey, Carnivus, my phone, dog! Carnivus, thank you for the tier fucking one for 11 months. That's a long ass time, bro. Shout out to you, homie. Shout out. Fuck! please sit. Alright, where were we? Oh, that looked great. That looked great. Great disrespect. Let's flip into the fucking... I know it's gonna be a 50, but look. Is he in front of you, yes or no? Yes. So you don't fucking flip again as if you could reach. My phone just fucking fell again. If the fucker is in front of you and he's gonna beat you to it, why are you so fucking desperate? Like a fucking dog, you're like... You can't fucking reach. Stop trying to reach. It's that easy. Accept the fact he's in front of you. Go opposite side of the play. Let him fucking pinch your shit. You sit here, you go here. You wait here, grab two passes, you sit here. Don't flip into the fucking ball because the ball's gonna go over your fucking head. Right? If this pinch went middle, tell me it was middle. Tell me it was middle. No one. This fucking guy could be middle if he didn't fucking flip away like a cuck. Bad awareness from that guy. You don't just fucking flip under the fuck or behind the ball. You're playing as if you're from the fucking past, bro. Stay up to date. Stay aware, motherfucker. Saint Sleep, thank you for the Twitch Prime, man. Willie Do, thank you for the Twitch Prime for 4 months. Carnivus, thank you for the tier 1 for 11 months. Almost during a year that I've been sub to your ass. Cheers, man. I still need to go play old school RuneScape with you one day, man. Thank you for the sub, dude. Zygomatic, thank you for the tier 1 for 3 months. I do appreciate that, man. Thank you. Hope you're doing great, man. Ooh. Money-chan! Appreciate it, homie. What is that turn? Oh, I know it's 10 seconds. I know you need a goal. But it's still so stupid. Use your fucking eyes and turn based off of what you see. You don't turn based off of what you think or what you expect. Don't expect, oh, if he wins the 50, I'm gonna turn upfield. Watch and turn based off of what happens. If he wins the 50 and then we turn. You don't turn before shit happens, right? You probably wouldn't wanted to go for a bump there. Like, I would still recommend just waiting behind you. Let him control the play and you're here for a support role, right? There's two fucking people. If you bump one of them, what's that gonna do? Nothing. And you're also coming from behind your opponent, which means... Or you're behind your team, so he doesn't even know you're bumping. Garbage. Wait here. Let him control. Now when this shit happens, we can push up. Fake challenge him. You'll hit the ball. We'll turn around. We'll get a free ball here because he's gonna shoot. You control the ball. And then you have one good chance. You have one fucking good chance because this guy's gonna land here. You're gonna control the ball. And this could be a 2v1, right? If you went for clean possessions and if you fucking had a brain, you'd do that. But you don't, and you're just way too desperate. You're way too far up, and this is a 50, and you turn into the 50. Wait for the 50. If the 50 is won, you turn up into the 150. If the 50 is lost, you turn back because the 50 is lost. Turn based off of what you see. Please think about this rule. After every fucking, like, don't just grab boots and turn like this and then notice, oh, the 50 is lost. I need to go back. The ball went over your head. Turn on ball cam. Where's the ball? We turn into the ball. Please, goes for everyone. It doesn't matter what rank you are. Watch the fucking ball and turn into the ball. Don't just randomly turn based off of your fucking simulation in your head and your expectations and shit. Don't randomly turn. Your turns need to have meaning. You need to rotate, man. This shit happens. You get bumped, cool, but we can rotate like this and we'll have some pads and we're back. We are my teammate. If he misses, we're back. If he hits, we can push up now. But don't stay under the ball. Don't stay there with zero boost. You're not gonna do anything. That's a nice try. That's it. I was playing once, got Chan 3 luck, thought I was ready for 2v2. To be fair, you played like a fucking plat. What would be your key points? Everything. I would suggest you just staying away from twos. Just fucking go play ones, man. I swear it's almost like every single play that you were involved. Something shit happened. No offense. Maybe this was just one of your worst games ever. But, you know, don't disrespect Splat like that. Don't say that. You watch out with turns. Watch out with not rotating your fucking ball chaser. Let your teammate do some shit. If the ball goes over your head or the ball is, you know, you're under the ball or you've tried some shit and you land in the corner, you rotate away. If you notice your teammate is not there, you can grab a boost, turn around, fake challenge, or rotate away. If this is a free ball after this boost grab, then go for it. Otherwise, fake challenge, you go back again. Make sure you go for pads. Don't be so aggressive. Take your time. You're getting a lot of touches into your opponents when you're in the corner. You're trying to beat the opponents a lot in the corner, whereas if you just let them beat themselves, you get a free ball and you don't have to use as much boost. Your boost management is kind of bad. You use like 50 boosts for no fucking reason. You're trying to get hits on the ball where if you just let them beat you and the ball goes over your head to your teammates better, you fuck your own team up by still getting hits on the ball, still getting 50s. It's a lot of shit. Yeah, Shadow Puppet, I agree. Hope that, you know, hope that helped out though, Juniors. There's a lot of information you should be able to get from this. And I really hope it does help. Because, mofuck, you do be needing help.